For a lot of artists who are learning V-Ray for the first time, opening V-Ray render settings is like looking at your uncle's nasty car engine. Very complicated and lots of settings to adjust. Although Chaos Group made a lot of efforts to simplify the user interface, but still lots of beginners get confused when using it. Mainly because they saw some old V-Ray tutorials on YouTube when V-Ray settings required a good understanding and some adjustment before hitting the render button. To the point that some even gave up learning V-Ray because they heard that it's very difficult and decided to switch to another easier rendering engine such as Corona or Lumion. Not only that, but also there are some scammers selling you their magical script, claiming that it will give you faster and high quality renders in a few seconds. But in fact, these scripts are doing nothing except adjusting some V-Ray settings for you, and that's it. So, save your money, save your time and efforts, grab a cup of coffee or tea, and watch this video to the end. In this video, I will show you the easiest and quickest way to set up V-Ray render settings in just a few clicks for both interior and exterior scenes. Also, we will make some tests to see to what extent does the render setup actually affect the quality of the final renders. And in the end, I will show you a simple trick to get a clean render very fast while maintaining a good quality. All of that with no script needed. Hey, what's up guys, hope you are all doing well. If you are new here, I do videos about architecture design and visualization. So if you are interested, consider subscribing and turn on the bell so you don't miss any upcoming videos. And now, without further ado, let's start the tutorial. First of all, let's understand the general concept behind V-Ray render settings and what we are exactly doing. The job of V-Ray, or basically any rendering engine, is to make mathematical calculations for all the lights in the scene and its effect on the scene, including materials and geometries, to generate the final render. There are two types of algorithms used to make those calculations. The first one, called unbiased, or let's call it the most accurate one. The second one, called biased, or let's call it the fastest one. Although biased renders are more accurate than unbiased one, with a good engine configured well, you may not notice any difference in quality, but the difference in speed could be immense. And while most of rendering engines use only one of them, V-Ray on the other hand can switch between the both methods. So you can either use biased or unbiased depending on your need. Okay, enough of theories. Let's see that in practice. Okay guys, let's start. So normally, you will open V-Ray render setup by pressing F10 or from this icon, render setup. Okay. And here when it gets very complicated, so what's V-Ray, what's global switches, what's the M-sampler, what's the GI, brute force, and it seems very complicated. So it's really hard to any beginner to understand all of these things. And of course you can also open V-Ray render setup from the V-Ray toolbar. This is the icon for V-Ray render settings, and it's the same thing. Okay, so you can just press F10 or from the icons. But what I want to show you is V-Ray quick settings. This is really a powerful feature, and I don't see a lot of people like using it. Like even in the tutorials, like everyone just opened V-Ray render setup and play with it. I know it's really hard for any beginner to understand all of these things. Like it took me like years to understand every single thing in like what systems, settings, render elements. So I will advise any beginner to just use V-Ray quick settings. It's really simple to use, and I will show you an example to use it. So this is our scene. This is obviously an interior scene, so we will choose interior. And as you can see, we have exterior, interior, VFX and studio. Okay, so we choose interior. Now let's go to this slide. So we have accurate, fast. What are these basically means? As we explained in the beginning of this video, accurate means unbiased, okay? While fast means biased. So we have accurate and fast, unbiased and biased, okay? What's BF means? Brute force. What is light LC means? It means light cache. IM, a radius map. What are those? Open V-Ray render setups, and I will open it only to show you what's the meaning of them. So we have here in the GI tab, global illumination. We have those, the primary engine and secondary engine. So a radius maps, this is a radius map and light cache, okay? If we change it to brute force accurate, we have brute force, PF plus LC means brute force with light cache, okay? So as you can see, this is will affect everything we will do in the V-Ray quick settings, will adjust automatically on the V-Ray settings. So let's see the pocket image sampler. This is the noise threshold. If we adjust the anti-aliasing, AA means anti-aliasing quality, it will affect directly to the pocket image sampler, okay? To the noise threshold and min and max subs. And also everything we will do here. So the GI quality, global animation quality, shading quality, everything we will do here will directly affect on the V-Ray setting. So we will not need to open V-Ray settings again, okay? Close it, goodbye. Welcome to the V-Ray quick settings. Now, I've already done all the testing to save you a lot of time, because you know, it took me hours to finish all the renders. So let's see the highest quality we can get, okay? The best of the best, okay? So interior, we change it to brute force plus brute force. Accurate means unbiased, okay? So this is the high quality we will get. I make the slides, the GI quality 100%, the shading quality 100%, the anti-aliasing quality 100%, okay? So this is the best of the best. And this is the render that I've get, okay? So high quality render, very clean, like sharp render, the shadows are nice and fine, like everything looks perfect, okay? Even this is not a very high resolution render, but as you can see, everything looks sharp, okay? But it took me 1 hour and 51 seconds to complete, and I'm using Ryzen Threadripper 2950X, so it's very powerful CPU. So this is high quality, but it's also cost me a lot of time. Let's see the medium quality. So I will change it from accurate, from unbiased to biased render, and I'm going to use IM, which is a radius map with light cache, okay? I will decrease the GI quality to something like 40, shading quality also to 40, and the AI quality, anti-aliasing quality, let's say 52, okay? Something I forget to tell you, bucket mode and progressive mode. You can change it from here. Bucket means that these squares that appears and render your image like block by block. Progressive mean your image will render like as a one piece, but it will progressively become cleaner and cleaner until it reaches the final image. Normally for me, like, it's my preference to use bucket mode to see the squares, but I also use sometimes progressive mode if I want to see my render quickly, as fast as possible, okay? Okay, and I got these results. So this took me 2 minutes and 20 seconds to complete. And as you can see, it's also like, look like it's the same. So let's compare the two renders. Let's select this render, A. Let's select the high quality render. This is B, okay? And by the way, this is the history. If you don't know how to show it from here, from the H mark, okay, H icon, history. And you can save your render every time you render, you complete your render, hit save, and it will save you like this information about the resolution and how much time it's took you to complete, okay? So this is the high quality render, and B, A, the low quality render or the medium quality, and I will activate compare. So here is the low quality or medium quality, and here is the final quality. Let's zoom in and see the difference. So it's clear that the right side is much cleaner, the shadows are defined. Here we have some global illumination shadows, all of them are accurate, okay? In general, of course the accurate render give us like a sharp render, sharp image, clean materials, the shadows, everything is perfect, okay? But it took us like 2 hours to complete, while this render, the medium quality render, took us only 2 minutes to complete, 2 minutes and 20 seconds. So it's not that like big difference. You see the render settings will not change your lightings or materials or everything. It will not do something crazy. It will not. It's not like a magic to come to will transfer your image. It's the same thing, but with some minor details. So in shadows and sharpness, only this will affect the render settings. So if you are really want these settings, go for the higher quality. But if you want just a nice render, it doesn't make sense to like crank the the quality all the way up. Okay, so I will even go extreme and show you the lowest quality that I will go. So let's lower the GI to, let's say 9, the shading quality to 10, the AA, the anti-aliasing 20. Okay, and I will render it right now. So we'll in bucket mode render, and this will take us only seconds to complete. Okay, so only 24 seconds, and you probably saw me adjusting the quality even lower. So GI quality 6, shading quality 7, etc. As you can see, our image is really grainy. We have a lot of noise. Let's compare it with the high quality. So we'll change our A. We'll save it to the history, okay? And we'll make it as A. So this took us about 2 hours to complete. This took us about 20 seconds to complete. Okay, so the only thing I will say is the noise. It's really clear. And of course the shadow quality, GI quality is much nicer in the 2 hours. But in general, still it looks the same. It's the same except for the details. So nothing crazy. And for 24 seconds, wow, this is really not bad. Okay, so now let's see how to get rid from this noise in a simple way. Okay, so let's go to the VLA quick settings, go to settings. We will only add this thing. So go to render elements, add, and let's choose VLA denoiser. Okay, that's it. Close it. We don't want to see it. Okay, VLA quick settings. Now let's re-render our image and see the magic of the denoiser. And as you can see, like, it's rendering like a charm. And it will finish the render, and it will took about 2 seconds to calculate. See here, calculating the denoising. Okay, wow, 27 seconds. Okay. And we got rid of all the noising. The denoiser do a good job in like smoothing our render. And of course it's not high quality. You can see here we have some of the noise in the lights, in the shadows, of course. So it's not perfect. I'm not saying it's perfect, but it's a perfect way to create a fast render, or let's say an acceptable render with an acceptable quality. Okay, and if you compare it with the final image, in the right we have the higher quality image, and on the left we have the lower quality image. It's really not that much difference. Okay, so I just want to say that the render settings is not like a magic thing to transform your scenes from like cartoonish scene to a realistic scene. The most important thing is lighting, is materials, is the composition of the shot. This is the most thing that you want to put your time developing, testing, not just wasting your time on the render settings. You are an artist. Spend your time creating your art, not just playing with the settings, etc. Okay, you are not a programmer. Now let's move on to another scene. Okay, here I have a scene from Evolmotion. This is an exterior scene, and also we'll see the effect of the VLA quick settings on our scene. Okay, let's open the VLA quick settings. So the first thing, I've done the high quality image. So in this case, I've chose the brute force with a radiance, with the light cache, sorry. Okay, and also I've cranked the settings all the way up. And here, it took me 1 hour and 17 minutes to complete. Let's say this is A. As you can see, high quality image, high quality render, sharp render. Everything is fine, and this is not a high resolution render, like 1030 pixel by 1350. Now let's see the lower lower quality that we will go. So we'll decrease it all the way up to 6, 6, 10 or 12, something like that. I've already done it. Took me 1 minute to complete. This is a render in 1 minute. So also I've already rendered it using the V-Ray denoiser. As you can see here, I've added a V-Ray denoiser to the render elements, and this is the final image with the denoiser. Okay, this is, here it is. It took me about 1 minute and 5 seconds to complete. And as you can see, this is with the activating of the denoiser. So this is before denoiser. As you can see, very noisy floor and reflections. With the denoiser, everything becomes smooth and clean. Before denoiser and after denoiser. Let's compare it to the high quality one. So in the left we have the lower quality one, and on the right we have the full quality, or the best quality that we can get. It's not much really, and in my opinion, if you want something really fast, always use lower quality with denoiser, with V-Ray denoiser, and always use V-Ray quick settings. Spare your time, spare your efforts, focus more to build your scene, to build the composition. Don't waste your time on the settings. That's my advice, and I wish you have learned something new from this video. And by that, we have reached to the end of this video. I hope you have learned something new from it and find it helpful. If you do, smash the like button and share it with your friends. That will help the channel to grow. Leave a comment if you have another topic to cover. That's it for this video. See you in the next one. Take care. Bye bye.